Charlie, it's amazing to have you here today collecting an award for a piece of work that defied expectations and definitions for a lot of people. Can you talk about, for you, what Bandersnatch really is and what people's choices have revealed as they've interacted with your creation?
For me, I don't know what it is. I don't know whether Bandersnatch is a film or a game or an episode. I don't really know. So I guess it's a hybrid of, it's a mongrel is what it is. In terms of what people's choices say about them, that's a really difficult one because obviously when you're writing something like this, you try to second guess what you think people will do, but you also have to accommodate what you think will be the path less traveled, as it were. And actually, in practice, it's turned out that my predictions of what was what aren't necessarily that accurate and that people are more psychotic than I imagined.
Every time you do Black Mirror, you manage to attract the finest pool of acting talent. Can you talk a little bit about, specifically for Bandersnatch, the young stars that you've assembled, particularly, I think, Will and Finn? I mean, such brilliant stars.
Well, I think both of them, like Finn we'd seen in Dunkirk, and Will I'd seen most recently in Detroit, which I don't know if you've seen Detroit. He's terrifying in that film. And I think it was one of those situations where we met them and chatted to them, and very quickly that we had a sense that they're both very, very smart and very, very committed to what they're doing. And so what they were doing was very challenging, obviously, because it was very much unlike filming most dramas. There was no linear through line, and so they had to sort of stay on top of a lot of variables in their head, and neither of them were at all fazed by the prospect of doing that. They were both actively welcoming the chaos, I think, in many ways. So that was one of the things that was great about it. And I think they've both done an amazing job, really, in something that we always wanted for you to first and foremost identify with the characters and enjoy the characters and not get too caught up in the gimmick of the interactivity to ignore that. And I think they did an amazing job.
Obviously, Black Mirror is a show that thrives on originality of ideas and storytelling. But I think one of the episodes, Black Museum, a lot of fans online were speculating, bore slight similarities to previous musings of Mr. Carl Pilkington. I'm curious if you'd heard that and how you felt about that, because there were sort of a couple of storylines in that episode that were sort of very unique stories, but seemed a little oddly like some of the ramblings of our favourite idiot abroad.
Yeah, I did hear that, and that was a bit embarrassing when you hear it. Genuinely, I didn't. So it was genuinely a coincidence. The Doctor story, because as I understand it, he had a similar idea to the dead wife in the head, was what we called it, and the Doctor story. The Doctor story had come from a story from Penn Jillette, from Penn and Teller, and he'd written it in like 1980. So maybe Carl Pilkington had. And the other one was just an idea that I'd had that was off the back of doing San Junipero. So I guess it's one of those things that we unfortunately looked like plagiarists.
What does it mean for you to be collecting this specific honour for the incomparably unique and magnificent Bandersnatch?
You're too kind. It's great. Feels great. Very flattered.
Can you talk a little bit about the extraordinary response that the series has had and what it was about the project that most excited you as a storyteller when you first picked up that unique script?
I was always a massive fan of Black Mirror. I'd seen all of the episodes, so it was more just, I knew that it was something I wanted to be involved in when I auditioned for it. When I got the audition alone, I was excited, and when I got the part, I was kind of over the moon, you know. So I was just in general, but then when I heard the concept, actually at first when I heard the concept, I worried that it could come across as gimmicky, but then once I'd read the script and had a sit-down meeting with Charlie and Annabelle and they talked me through it all, I realised it wasn't going to be at all. And it was going to be really well done and everything, so it was only natural.
What is it about Charlie and Annabelle as storytellers that assuage those fears that won you over so quickly?
They're incredibly, I mean, obviously incredibly talented and incredibly intelligent, but also very precise, and they think about all of the details. Them and their whole team are incredibly hardworking. I think they probably didn't sleep for the whole time we were making it. Constantly fixing things that they need fixing, and which have a real attention to detail, which I really respect. And I think it's, you can tell they care very much about what they're putting out, which I always think comes across, you know.
In terms of detail, obviously, fans, I'm sure, when they meet you, share their favourite moments from the adventure. I'm curious, are there particular episodes, particular moments that you find the most rewarding or most pleased with when you see the final product?
Definitely the bit I enjoyed reading the most when I got the script and I got the Twine document to sort of run it through all was the... It's the section where you realise it's all a film set. I thought that was just so funny and kind of ballsy to put in. It's incredibly meta, you know.
And of course, you're working with great people behind the camera, but amazing people in front of the camera as well, including one of our favourite human beings, Mr. Will Poulter, who's here today. Can you talk a little bit about what it was like working with the rest of the cast on Bandersnatch?
Yeah, it was amazing. I was like, sort of... I don't know. I landed on my feet somehow. I got the luckiest with all of the cast. You know, with Asim, with Will, with Craig, with Alice. Everyone was just amazing. I couldn't have asked for better people to work with. I was kind of in awe the whole time I was doing it. Just incredibly grateful. So, yeah.
I think the most rewarding thing about Black Mirror as a series is that audiences always take something unique from each episode, each series, and there's a lot of different symbolism and layers. I'm curious, for you with Bandersnatch, at the heart of that, what did you most take away from that story? What do you think audiences should be latching onto as the central theme or message of Bandersnatch?
I think that it's quite open to interpretation, to be honest. One of the things that really stood out for me was it encourages you not to just take in information passively when you're watching the TV. You are forced to sort of think about the choices you make and engage in it. Whereas it's very easy now, I think, with your sort of home entertainment systems to zone out and be on your phone and be distracted and not really think about the information you're taking in. Whereas this forces you to by making you interact with it.
What other projects have you got coming up at the moment? Because we love everything you do and we can't wait for hopefully much more of it.
Oh, thank you so much. I've got a film called Roads that I did, Sebastian Schipper directed, and starring alongside Stefan Back, that'll be coming out this summer. And I've got a film called Port Authority that'll be out at some point. And I was in a film called Don't Tell a Soul that will be out at some point soon. I don't know when.
Fantastic. My final question, have you got a message to all the Black Mirror fans out there who love this series and are so glad that you made it?
Thank you so much for supporting. And yeah.